Hey, what's up guys, NMX here, hope you're all doing well, and in today's video, I'm going to be showing you how you can improve your FPS and input latency in Fortnite Season 8. And also, in this guide, I'll be going over some BIOS tweaks, which I've never actually covered in any of my older videos before, since I've always wanted to keep it basic and simple, so that even the people with absolutely no knowledge about computers can still do it. But now, I just kinda wanna step it up a little, even if it's just as small as 2 or 3 BIOS settings. And trust me guys, it's really easy to do if you just follow my steps correctly. But anyway, with all that being said, let's get into the video. Alright, so first thing you wanna do is download the pack, link down below in the description. And after you download it, you will simply just need to extract it and then open it. And in here, we're going to start with the first folder, which is just one registry file. So this registry file disables UAC, which we will need to do before doing any of the steps in this video, because if we don't do it, then all the CMD scripts in this video might not work for you. So basically just double click disable UAC, click yes, and then click OK, and then make sure to restart your PC before doing the rest of the steps. If you don't restart your PC, then it's just as if you didn't do it at all, and you will face issues while trying to do the rest of the steps of this video, so please make sure to restart your PC right after. After you've restarted your PC, you now want to go to the power tweaks folder, which will simply just contain tweaks that will make your computer care less about power and instead focus more on performance and latency. So when you're in here, you will see a script that allows you to download and use my custom made power plan, which is really good for FPS and system latency. So to import it, simply just double click the CMD script called import NMX power plan, and after that you can click on the power plan shortcut and there you should see my power plan. Make sure to activate it, and then you can exit out of here. And then for disable power throttling registry file, this simply just prevents Windows from limiting your performance to conserve power. This feature is supposed to only do this to unneeded processes, but it doesn't really work as expected, so I really recommend disabling it. If you're on a laptop though, and your temps are pretty high, I wouldn't really apply this. So to disable power throttling, just double click the registry file, click yes, and then click OK. After you are done, you want to go back and now go to the GPU tweaks folder, and then in here select your GPU. In my case that is Nvidia, so I'm gonna cover the Nvidia folder first. In here you want to start by downloading the Nvidia profile inspector from the shortcut provided. Simply just double click it and it should open your browser and start downloading Nvidia profile inspector. After it's downloaded, just move it to this folder and then drag the NIP file called new optimized profile over Nvidia profile inspector, and then lift off your finger and it should say applied successfully. When it says that, you can just click OK. So this profile is new and improved than the one I provided in my recent video, since the one in that video didn't really work for everyone as one of the settings was driver dependent, but either way this profile optimizes all your Nvidia 3D settings for latency and performance. So now let's cover the AMD GPU tweaks folder. So in here you will see a few registry files. You want to start with the disable ultra low power state registry file, which is pretty self-explanatory. It just tells your GPU not to go into low power state, which can really be beneficial for performance and latency when disabled. Then for the second registry file, it will simply just tweak some settings that are available in the Radeon software. After you are done with the GPU tweaks, you can now go back and now for disable Spectre and Meltdown Windows patches. I've already made a video about this before stating how beneficial disabling these patches is for your CPU performance, so if you want to go ahead and watch that video, I'll put it at the top left of the screen right now. So to disable them, just double click the registry file, click yes, and click OK. After you've done that, you now want to go back, and now you want to run the disable memory compression script. So memory compression is one of the most useless features in Windows, unless you have like a 4GB RAM notebook or something, because memory compression just hinders your CPU performance, which causes a lot of stutters, so I really recommend you all to disable it. Also, you might notice that I got an error here, but that's just because I'm on my own custom Windows install, which has features that memory compression relies on removed. So it's fine, but for most of you, you shouldn't really get an error. Anyway, after that, you wanna now double click delete temp files, which will just clear out your temporary files folders to free up space. Same thing for the next file, which just deletes any log files that are on your PC, which 99.99% you will never actually need. Anyway, after you've done that, the next step is only for people that keep Spotify or Discord open while they play games. So, basically we're just gonna change two settings in Discord settings and one setting in the Spotify app. These settings will change the way Discord or Spotify consume your PC resources, which helps a lot with input delay and game freezes as well. So first, for Spotify, you just want to go to Spotify settings, scroll down and then click advanced, then uncheck enable hardware acceleration. And then for Discord, you want to go to Discord settings, advanced tab, and uncheck hardware acceleration. So basically, hardware acceleration just lets the program, which in this case is Spotify or Discord, to use your GPU to enhance the app's performance. But that can cost your game a lot of FPS and input delay if you keep Discord or Spotify open while you play games. So disabling hardware acceleration actually fixes that. But there is one more setting in Discord that actually helps a lot with FPS drops and freezes, which is Discord's in-game overlay feature. The feature that basically just shows you like a notification over your game when someone sends you a message or speaks in your call if you have Discord open while you're playing games. Disabling in-game overlay actually helps a lot with freezes and FPS drops. Alright, so now that we are done with the Windows stuff, now let's get into the BIOS tweaks. So since I will be keeping it as simple as possible, we are only going to cover two simple BIOS settings in this video. But first, I need to show you how to get to BIOS on your PC. So there is multiple ways to get into BIOS. One of the simplest ones is to do it through recovery mode by simply just clicking your Windows key and R at the same time, and then you wanna type in ms-settings, two dots above each other, and then recovery. After that, click enter, then in here you wanna click restart now. This will simply restart your PC to recovery mode, and when you're there, you simply just wanna click on troubleshoot, then advanced options, then click UE5 firmware settings, and then click restart now, and it will restart to BIOS. So this was method 1, but this method won't always work for everyone. So if it doesn't work for you, you can do the second method, which is basically just spamming the key your specific BIOS requires for it to launch. You can do that by simply just restarting your PC, and while it's restarting, just spam that key. So some of you might not know the key that their BIOS requires, so you could search it up on Google. But for most of you, it will be delete key or F2. If neither work, just search it up or comment down below and I'll try to help you if I can. Anyway, when you're in your BIOS, you now want to look for the first setting we are going to change, which will be disabling CPU C states, which helps tremendously with CPU performance and also reduces system latency a lot. C states is basically just a CPU power saving technique, but there's a lot more to it than just that, so if you would like to find out some more, I'd recommend you do some research. Anyway, when you're in here, you want to look for C states in your BIOS. If you can't find it in your BIOS, you can easily just look it up on Google on how to disable C states for your specific motherboard model. But for Asus motherboards, it will most likely be in the advanced tab, and then CPU configuration, and then CPU power management control. For some MSI Ryzen motherboards, it will be in the overclocking tab, and then advanced CPU configuration, and then AMD CBS. Or for some other Ryzen motherboards, it will be in the overclocking tab and then CPU features tab. But either way guys, you will just need to look for it as the location and name might be different for different motherboards. After you find it, you just want to disable it. And now for the second setting, which is enabling XMP, which can also be known as DOCP. So XMP is simply just making your RAM run at the speed it's supposed to be running at. Because when you buy a RAM kit that is like, for example, 3600 MHz, it doesn't actually run at that unless you enable XMP. But I would just like to point out that overclocking RAM manually and testing stability is much better than enabling XMP. But if you're not advanced when it comes to PCs, then I just recommend you enable XMP, nothing else. But please keep in mind that not everyone's PCs are the same, and that some RAM kits are worse than others and some PCs are worse than others. So there is a chance that your XMP profile is unstable. And in that case, then your PC may not boot after you enable XMP. But keep in mind that this is just in the rare case of that your XMP profile is unstable. I've rarely seen this happen, so don't worry. And either way, as I just said, if XMP is unstable on your PC, you can simply just revert it by clearing CMOS, which will set all your BIOS settings, including XMP, to default as well. If you don't know how to clear CMOS, you can easily search it up on Google. So to enable XMP, you simply just want to go to your BIOS and look for the option called XMP, or DOCP, or Extreme Memory Profile. After you find it, you want to enable it or set it to Profile 1. After you've done that, you now want to save and exit your BIOS. After you've done all the steps, I would recommend you restart your PC a few times, for example 2 or 3 times. This will help make sure that everything is applied successfully. And after you've done that, you can now open your game and start testing out your performance and latency. So that was it for the video guys, I hope you all enjoyed it and that it helped you all out. Please make sure to like and subscribe if this video helped you. Stay safe, and I'll see you all in the next one.